Hello everyone, welcome to Beaver Shopee channel. In this video, I'm gonna modify the Mini Qt RQ1 to build an ultimate budget drifter. And I'll also show you how to properly build this car and how to set up RC car electronics. First thing first, this is a budget build, so I'll keep using as much original parts as I can, including the use of AAA batteries to keep the cost down, because buying LiPo battery and charger will increase the cost significantly. And some of you might not want that, but if you already have LiPo battery, by all means use it. It is much lighter and the car's ballast will be better. With that out of the way, let's look at the things I'll put in the car. A new servo, capacitors, new ESC, receiver, front one-way, metal swing shafts, tuning springs, and to top everything off, let's put some good drift tires on it. If your circuit board is still working, you don't have to convert it to use separated ESC, servo and receiver. Just upgrade the front one-way, metal swing shafts, springs, and probably tires, and you'll get a great budget drift car. If you want precision, upgrade the electronics and it'll be fantastic. First, I'm gonna replace the servo. Let's start by removing the circuit board and the top plate. If you use servo from MiniQ, WL Toys 128th, or JJRC Q35, it'll be a perfect fit. But what I'm using is the PowerHD 1600A servo, a standard 5G servo. As you can see here, it is longer than the original servo. So what I'm gonna do is replacing the back cover with the original servo. The motor doesn't fit inside, so I'll cut the back cover off. I also have to trim the servo tray on the chassis too. Luckily, the spindle is the same, so I can use the servo saver and the horn directly without mod. There is a bit of gap between the steering rod and the servo, so I'm gonna fill it by putting a shrink tube on the servo horn. Now I can fit it in with no problem and minimal slop. Next, I'll solder some capacitors to the motor to reduce the electrical noise. I'm still using the original motor because it is already enough for drifting. The capacitor I need is non-polar, number 104, or 0.1 microfarad. There are three configurations of doing this. One capacitor, two capacitors, and three capacitors. What I'll do is two capacitors, where one leg is on each terminal, and the other leg is on the motor can, because it is easier to fit inside the chassis this way. Don't forget to check if the capacitors interfere with motor mount or rub against the center shaft. As it turned out, this one is almost perfect. I only have to trim it a bit right here, so the motor fits perfectly. Now I'll grind the poles on the top plate out so I can stick ESC and receiver down easier later. With that done, I'll leave the electronics for now and proceed with upgrading the car. I will upgrade four things. Front one-way, metal swing shafts, tires, and the springs all at the same time because I have to disassemble the whole car anyway. So, doing everything all at once is easier than keep coming back for each upgrade. The first upgrade is replacing the front spool with one-way. What is it and why should you upgrade, you might ask? Well, I'll use my Mini QQ7 to demonstrate. Front one-way will allow the wheels to spin forward freely and separately on both sides. To put it simply, it works like the rear wheel of a bicycle. When you stop pedaling, the bike is still rolling forward. And that's what front one way will do to the front wheels. So when you let go of the throttle, the front wheels are still rolling and you can make the back swings out easily. When you brake, the front will roll and the rear will slip, which is like you are pulling the handbrake. In conclusion, we use front one way to have the handbrake effect and make the car easier to drift. However, there are some cautions when using it. You can only use it in the front, because it only works in one direction. And because of the rolling effect, you will lose the brake and reverse on the front wheels. Here's the front one way from Mini Q provided by Banggood. Link to buy is in the description below. The name on the website is confusing because it says head unit for some reason. So don't mind that and just remember, head unit means front one way. Replacing is easy. Open the front gearbox. Pull the old diff out. Pull the bearings out and put them on the new diff. It's also better if you drop some lube into the one way. I'm using the bicycle share lube because it's easy to find and it works for me. There's a problem here. This one way doesn't come with shims as in the photos, and it won't fit properly. You'll need 6x8mm shims like this. Well, it's a good investment anyway, because you'll never know which diff needs shimming. The shims that I use are from Atomic. Try experimenting with it until you have good gear mesh. It should look like this, having a bit of slack and not too tight. And this is a good time to upgrade the drive shaft to metal as well. Not that the plastic ones that come with the car are going to break that easily, because this car is not that fast, but upgrading it to metal will make it much more rigid and much smoother. Here's the upgrade from Mini Q, once again provided by Banggood. You'll need two sets of this, one for the front and one for the rear. The installation is easy. Just pull the old one out and put the new one in. Again, there's a problem with fitting and need some shims. What you need here are M3 shims. They really dropped the ball in this batch. It used to be perfect fit, but now it needs a lot of shims just to get it working. If you want to try your luck, then okay. But if you want something that works without shims, just get metal swing shafts for Mini Z all-wheel drive. This is also a good time to upgrade the wheels and tires. I'm using original Mini Z all-wheel drive narrow wheels, 1.5mm offset, and Mini Z drift tires. When fitting the wheel, do not over-tighten it. It should not move from side to side, but it should be able to spin freely like this. If it is too tight, loosen the nut until it can spin. You might also have to adjust the shims as well. Before putting the gearbox back together, let's tune the car by changing the springs. Here are the springs from 3 Racing for Mini Z all-wheel drive. I'm gonna use soft springs at the front and hard springs at the back, so the car has tendency to oversteer, making it easier to drift. Now I can close the front gearbox. Moving on to the back, again, replace the plastic drive shafts with metal. Change the wheels and put new springs on. With that done, I can put the top plate back on. And that's it for drivetrain upgrade. Now back to the electronics. I'm replacing the all-in-one board with separated ESC and receiver. This is a car ESC with brake for brush motor. It works with 1-cell LiPo battery, 4 AAA batteries, up to 2-cell LiPo battery. This ESC is the old unit from Sinohobby, and you can't find it anymore. You can use a generic 20A brush ESC with brake. It'll work just the same. You might also have to do some soldering to convert the plugs. For this car, I plug the motor in first, then stick the ESC down with double-sided tape. As for the radio, my first try was FlySky, because it can move the servo further than other radios, and I thought I need more steering. In the end, the standard range is enough. So I replaced it with Radio Link to show you that you can still have gyro after upgrade and to show you how to set it up. Here's how to plug the wires into the receiver. Servo to channel 1. ESC to channel 2. Check the polarity of the receiver to see where the signal, positive and negative, are connected to. The receiver should have some labeling on it to show you how to plug the wires in. On the servo and ESC, normally, white or yellow wire is signal and black or brown is negative. Don't plug it in the wrong way because it might short-circuit it and end up frying the whole system. As for the battery, I'm gonna continue using 4 AAA batteries because this is a budget build. You can use LiPo battery if you want, it'll be lighter, and if you use 2-cell LiPo battery, it'll be much faster. Next is setting up the transmitter. You have to check the steering and throttle to make sure they work properly. If the steering direction is wrong, reverse the channel 1 or steering channel. Next, moving on to the throttle. You have to check the function of the ESC first, then check the direction of the car later. It has to run when you pull the trigger, then brake or stop when switching directly from pulling to pushing. Now come back to the center, then push again to run in the opposite direction. If it doesn't work like this, you have to reverse the channel 2 or throttle channel. If the function is correct, but the car is running the wrong way, you have to swap the motor wires. Now try to run it and adjust the steering trim to make the car go in straight line. If you have to put a lot of trim in channel 1 to make it go straight, it's better to take the servo out and rotate the horn one step to the direction you need to trim. Then finally, set the EPA or endpoint on the steering to only what the car can do, so you don't put too much stress on the servo. You can check it by turning to full lock on each side. If the servo is whining, then you have to turn it down. You have to do this setting separately for both left and right. Also, try to run it on the floor and adjust the EPA to make it turn left and right equally. Next is the gyro setup. This is the setup for Radio Link. If you use different radio system that has gyro, for example, FlySky GT5 or Spectrum with AVC, please consult your manual. First, the gyro needs to activate when going forward. As you can see here, when I pull the trigger, the gyro doesn't work, but it does when I go backward, so I have to swap the gyro activation direction. It is one click on the receiver. And here it is. Next is gyro direction. It has to counter steers or turning into the direction that the car swings. What you are seeing here is not how it should work. To reverse the gyro direction, click it twice. To adjust the gyro gain, use the VR knob. As you can see here, higher gain gives me more counter steer. If the gain is too high, the car will understeer, so don't use too much gain, otherwise you won't be able to drift. Personally, I don't use gyro, so I turn it off by clicking it 3 times. And the light turns green, indicating the gyro is off. And it is done. Now I have a perfectly working car with gyro, even though I don't use it. And here's the car after upgrades. I also add 10 grams to the front to add a bit more traction. Let's go for test drive. Now it is much easier to drift. Steering is faster and much more precise. Turning in is sharper and it's easier to initiate a drift. And there you have it, the ultimate budget drifter. Enjoy the drifting footage and see you again next time.